Final red wine is a real oddball. It's not very, very, very much not mainstream, thank you. But I think it would be wrong of me to ignore the trends in the wine world, which I will outline if I'm told I have time, which are taking things to an extreme. And a lot of younger newcomers to wine are looking for much more, a greater range of styles than was the norm, say, 10 years ago. And they don't mind if they'll never be able to afford a Grand Cru Burgundy or an ancient vintage port or a first growth Bordeaux. What they want to do is experiment, and they want a range of different ways of making wine, a range of places that wine comes from, and they love finding out about new ways to make wine. So this is a wine made very defiantly and deliberately in amphora, and there it is, in Alentejo, and not in Vidigueira, in fact. It's in an area designed, for vineyards designed to showcase the particular qualities of Vidigueira. It's only 12.5% alcohol. It's not a mix of conventional grapes. The most 40% Trincadera, 30% Moreto, 30% Tinta Grossa. And very, very different. I did taste the this is 2015. I may have said it was 16. I tasted the 16 and was a completely different wine. I don't know if you found this was difficult to sell or what, but this is, so it's like a sort of mountain stream. I think if you were to give this blind to someone and tell them it came from southern Portugal, they wouldn't believe you, because it is so refreshing. It's the sort of red wine that could be served relatively cool, chock full of fruit, but then encased in this kind of stoniness that amphora treatment gives the wine, which I'm finding more and more in the wines I'm tasting from around the world. And so I think all wine people interested in wine would be well advised to open their eyes and palates to newer styles of wine. Certainly to just try them and see where some of these younger wine producers are going. Some of them succeed, some of them don't. But this is a very attractive, sort of peppery kind of wine that really, you know, some reds are so big and heavy that they dull the palate. This one titillates it and sort of gets the sort of saliva flowing. Would go really well with a lot of your seafood, actually, because of course there are so many reds that do. But this is a excellent one. Lovely, lovely stuff. Thank you. And needless to say, all indigenous yeast, no added cultured yeast. This is a big trend. So that was chosen just to illustrate. You know, I could have chosen others, but something to show to celebrate the future, possible avenues for Portuguese wine. Not that everyone should go there, but and experimentation, because we can't, as you have demonstrated over the last 10 years, you can't sit still. Everything evolves, including wine and how it's made and how it tastes.
Fiquei muito surpreendido com esta distinção. Isto é um projeto muito recente, um projeto paralelo, um projeto pessoal meu. E que surgiu da necessidade de criar vinhos que de alguma forma vão de encontro a que alguns os mercados vão pedindo, mas que são também vinhos fora da caixa, vinhos que expressam de uma maneira mais pura, autêntica, o terroir de onde são originários, neste caso Vidigueira. E nesse sentido fiquei muito surpreendido pela Jancis Robinson, a escolher o Bojador Vinho de Talha como um dos 10 vinhos portugueses nestes 10 anos.